Hello everyone. So today we will see about speed control methods of induction motor. Okay, the speed control methods. There are a lot of methods in speed controlling for especially for induction motor. As we seen in some previous semesters regarding the speed control methods of DC motors. Okay, so again in the DC machine and transformer subject we have seen about the speed control methods of DC motors. Okay, for as we using the speed control mechanism for controlling the speed of that particular machine. Okay, so this speed control actually basically need for any industrial purpose, or suppose you are going to apply this methodology for in different applications. So for that purpose you require the different methodologies to control the speed of that particular motors. Okay, so as we have mentioned the topic name as speed control methods of induction motor. So I'm taking the some examples which is related in your day-to-day common life. Okay, day-to-day life. Okay, so suppose I have one ceiling fan which is nothing but which operates on the induction motor principle. This operates on the induction motors. So suppose I want to control its speed. That means now I have ceiling fan. I have simple coil. I have simple fan, and I want to control its speed. That means suppose I want to get more and more air from that particular fan, I will change its speed. Okay, so for that controlling the speed of that particularly that fan, we require some control mechanism. Also, I call this a control methodologies for its controlling of this particular speed. Okay, so again, suppose we have some induction motor we have already installed in some industries for any purposes. So in that cases, lot of industry works depends on the induction motor work, induction motors applications. Okay, so that for particular induction for particular applications I require a little bit smaller, little bit lower speed, or in some cases I require a higher speed. That means suppose you are taking the example of electrical traction, that means electrical train. In that cases I always require the variable speed. That means firstly when the train is going to start, obviously at the initial stage the speed is zero. Then once the motor, that is a train, is going to start, then it will increase its speed. Okay, and again at the nearest station, suppose I want to stop the particular train, then I have to decrease the speed. Okay, for that purpose I require the increase as well as decrease. That is nothing but a speed control methods or the speed control mechanism of the induction motors. So for this lecture we will see about how the induction motor speed can be controlled. Okay, so for the speed control methods, before going in deep about the speed control, we will see about this formula. Okay, so as we need the as we seen in the previous some few lectures ago, so we will see about the speed, actual speed of induction motor as well as synchronous speed. Okay, so before going to control, at least we should recall some memories related with the speed. Okay, our speed formulas. So as I know that there are two speed induction motor, this particular first is nothing but an NS. I called NS. It is nothing but a synchronous speed. S indicates synchronous, and for it is a letter for abbreviation for the speed. So NS is equals to synchronous speed, which has given by 120 into F divided by P. This is already we seen in previous lectures, where NS equals to synchronous speed in RPM, that is a revolution per minute. F is a supply frequency, which is always in 50 hertz, as well as P is equals to number of poles. Okay, this is synchronous speed. This synchronous speed is nothing but it is a speed of the rotating magnetic field in the induction motors. Okay, so this synchronous speed always it is nothing but a constant speed. Okay, so here the second term is related with the actual speed. So I mentioned here an R. This R indicates the rotor speed, or simply we call it as the actual speed of induction motor. So NR is equals to 1 minus S into NS, and NS equals to 120 F upon V, because already we have seen this. So therefore I want to replace this NS by 120 F upon P. So I will get NR is equals to 120 F upon P into bracket 1 minus S, or simply called as this one. Okay, suppose you want to control, suppose this NR. Okay, so as I know that NR equals to 1 minus S into NS. Okay, so that means what? Suppose I want to control this NR, I want to change this NR, I should change the NS. Okay, just try to understand the concept. Okay, as I mentioned, NS equals to 120 F upon P. So suppose I want to control the actual speed. Okay, this is a formula which is related to the actual speed of induction motor. Okay, So this one nr, that is n is equals to ns will bracket 1 minus s, or simply called as n is equals to 1 minus s into ns. Okay, so I want to control, if I want to control the actual speed called the rotor speed of induction motor, then I have to control the value of ns, because as we seen this particular relation, there is a direct relation between the actual speed of induction motor with the synchronous speed of induction motor. Okay, so as I know that synchronous speed has a formula, this one ns equals to 120 f upon p. Now suppose how we are going to change the ns. Now basically I said that nr, that is actual speed of motor, is depend on the ns. Okay, if I change the ns, obviously nr will get changed. Okay, now firstly I will think about how I can change the value of ns. So as I know that ns equals to 120 f upon p, okay, there are two terms which is related with the ns, that is frequency as well as the p, that is nothing but a number of poles. Now if I change the frequency, as I know that supply frequency is 50 hertz constant, but by using some methodology, some mechanism, suppose I have changed the frequency of that particularly supply which is given to the induction motor, obviously my synchronous speed will get changed. Okay, that means there is a direct relation, that is ns equals to 120 f. Suppose I kept this 120 as a constant, so ns equals to f upon p. Okay, so ns is directly proportional to f, while ns is inversely proportional to p. Okay, so if I change the frequency, obviously my speed will get changed, that is the synchronous speed will get changed, as well as if I change my number of poles, that is a p is nothing but a number of poles. Okay, so if I change my number of poles, obviously my synchronous speed will change, and if I change the synchronous speed, obviously that nr, that is the actual speed of motor, will get changed. Okay, so we will see about how the control mechanism of speed which is applied for the induction motors. Okay, so again, this is the basic reason, this is the basic formula which are basically used to control the speed of induction motor. So as we seen in previous lectures, so actually we are going to control the ns only. Obviously if you are controlling the ns, it will change the actual speed of motor, that is the n. Okay, so these are the some methods which is used for the speed control of induction motors. Okay, the first method is stator voltage control method, second one pole changing method, third one rotor resistance control method, and last one variable voltage variable frequency, that is a VVVF, this is a triple VF. Okay, again there are lot of methods of speed control of induction motor. Okay, but I'm taking only these because it is mentioned in your syllabus. Okay, suppose I consider the total speed control mechanism or speed control methods, now it goes on increasing. That means I have already taken the 4 points, that is the first one stator voltage control method, second pole changing method, third rotor resistance, fourth one variable voltage resistance. Okay, variable voltage variable frequency methods. Again, suppose I'm considering all the speed control methods, then again it's part of stator voltage control method. Obviously second one is the frequency changing method, third one is the pole changing method, and regarding this rotor resistance again, rotor resistance again has a three different types, and last one is a variable voltage variable frequency. Okay, but for your typical curriculum, you have mentioned only these 4 points of the speed control mechanism. Okay, so we will take about the one first this control mechanism one by one. Okay, so first one, it's nothing but a stator voltage control method. Okay, so stator voltage, that means if I applied the lower voltage, or simply called if I change the supply voltage, obviously my speed will get changed. How are we getting this? Because in a previous lectures we already seen about the relation between the speed as well as the voltage. Okay, that means there is a direct relation between speed and the supply voltage. Now we will see the detail about this. Now the first part is nothing but a stator voltage control method. Okay, so we will move towards this one. These are the simple different speed control methods, so we will see about one by one methods of the speed control. Okay, so first part is nothing but a स्टेटर वोल्टेज कंट्रोल मेथड. एज ए नेम स्पेसिफाइड द डिटेल इंफॉर्मेशन ऑफ द मैकेनिज्म. ओके, सो नेम नेम इज गिवन एज स्टेटर वोल्टेज कंट्रोल मेथड. दैट मीन्स वी आर गोइंग टू कंट्रोल द स्टेटर वोल्टेज. ओके, त्या मेथड मध्ये काय करतात, तर कंट्रोल मेथड हे सगळं स्पीड कंट्रोल मेथडच आहे, बट ह्याच्यामध्ये स्पेशली जे नावात दिले त्याचं मिनिंगच नावात दिलेलं आहे. ओके, सो आय मेन्शन हियर. ओके, सो हियर एज फर्स्ट पार्ट इज द स्टेटर वोल्टेज. एज द नेम इंडिकेट्स द टोटल इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑफ दॅट पर्टिक्युलर मेथड. ओके, फर्स्ट पार्ट इज नथिंग बट अ स्टेटर वोल्टेज कंट्रोल मेथड. ओके, सो वी विल सी द स्पीड ऑफ थ्री फेज इंडक्शन मोटर कॅन बी वॅरीड बाय वॅरिंग द सप्लाय वोल्टेज. एज वी ऑलरेडी नोन दॅट द टॉर्क डेव्हलप इज प्रपोर्शनल टू स्क्वेअर ऑफ द सप्लाय वोल्टेज अँड द स्लिप ऑफ मॅक्सिमम टॉर्क इज इंडिपेंडंट ऑफ सप्लाय वोल्टेज. दिस मेथड गिव्ज अ स्पीड कंट्रोल ओनली बिलो द नॉर्मल रेटेड स्पीड. ओके, सो वॉट इज एक्झॅक्टली इन दिस मेथड? हियर वी आर गोइंग टू चेंज द स्टेटर वोल्टेज. दॅट मीन्स व्हेन ऍक्च्युली नाव द स्पीड कंट्रोल मेकॅनिझम इज अप्लिकेबल आफ्टर द मशीन इज वर्किंग ऑर मशीन इज रनिंग ऍट द नॉर्मल कंडिशन्स. ड्युरिंग स्टार्टिंग वी कांट कंट्रोल द स्पीड. ओके, सो कांट अप्लाय द स्पीड कंट्रोल मेकॅनिझम. ओके, सो वन्स युअर मोटर इज गोइंग टू गेटिंग द स्टार्टेड नॉर्मल ऑपरेटिंग कंडिशन्स एज दॅट इन दॅट केस वी आर ऑलरेडी वी विल कंट्रोल द स्पीड ऑफ इंडक्शन मोटर्स. ओके, सो फर्स्ट द नेम इज गिवन अ स्टेटर वोल्टेज कंट्रोल मेथड. सो हियर वी आर गोइंग टू कंट्रोल द स्टेटर वोल्टेज ऑफ इंडक्शन मोटर. नाव आय ऑपरेटेड द मशीन. नाव आय गिवन द सप्लाय टू द थ्री फेज गिवन द सप्लाय थ्री फेज सप्लाय टू द स्टेटर वाइंडिंग ऑफ इंडक्शन मोटर. देन इट विल स्टार्ट रोटेटिंग. ओके, देन रोटर विल रोटेट अँड इट विल स्टार्ट रोटेटिंग. नाव सपोज आय वॉन्ट टू कंट्रोल. कंट्रोल मीन्स वॉट? आयदर आय शुड डिक्रीज द स्पीड or I should increase the speed. Okay, so near about I know that my actual speed of motor is almost equal to a synchronous speed. Near about that means suppose my synchronous speed is about 1500, that is 1500 rpm speed. Okay, actual synchronous speed, then my actual speed is near about 1490 if it is no load conditions, or sometimes due to load application it may be decreases. That means up to 1400 rpm, etc. Okay, so here for typical this method I want to control the stator voltage. Stator voltage by using any means you can control the stator voltage. Either you can control the stator voltage by first its auto transformer, just as we seen in the some auto transformer starter, we are applying the auto transformer for starting purpose. Okay, so if you are giving the 400 volt, for example, now motor is operating normally. Okay, now if the motor is operating normally, suppose you are changing the voltage of the stator by changing the auto transformer. Okay, that is the auto transformer simple called a dimmer. So obviously the voltage input given to the motor will change and hence its speed will change. Okay, this is first method. Again, second method of the stator voltage control is just apply the external resistance in the series of stator connections. Okay, that means this one. Okay, so I have mentioned the variable voltage for speed control can be obtained by the following methods. Okay, this is related to stator voltage control method. So this stator voltage can be controlled by using the following methods. First one, by connecting an external resistance in the stator circuit of the motor. That is a connection of external resistance in the stator circuit of the motor. Second, by using an auto transformer. Third, by using a thyristor voltage controller. Last one, by using a track controller. So diac and track you already seen in some power electronic subjects. So these two are related with the electronic base, and these two already be seen in the starter of induction motor point. Okay, so first we will see one by one by connecting the external resistance in the stator winding. So if I connect the external resistance in the stator winding, obviously my voltage applied to the induction motor will change and I can change the speed of induction motor. Second part is regarding it auto transformer. Now I given the 400 volt supply through the auto transformer. Now machine is rotating normally. Suppose I want to change, I want to decrease its voltage. Then obviously the if I decrease the output of auto transformer, then obviously the input of stator will get changed. That is input of induction motor voltage will change. And if the voltage is changed, that is if a voltage is decreased, obviously speed will decrease. Next one, it's a thyristor voltage controller. If my according to the firing angle of thyristor, I can change its working of thyristor, and hence I will change the voltage of induction. So we will see about the detail of this stator voltage control method one by one. So here the first method I have shown by using the external resistances, as this diagram is similar to that of your stator resistance starter. Okay, that is a stator resistance starter. In the stator resistance starter, we are already connected. We are going to connect the this stator resistances, we call external resistances in the stator circuit, so that the voltage of induction motor will change during the induction motor can be controlled during the starting period. Okay, so this same method we can use for the stator voltage control method. Okay, that means just after using this, that is by just after once I started the induction motor normally by using any starters. So now by varying these resistances which is connected to the stator of the induction motor, so we can again see there are three different circuit. This is one phase, I have connected one resistance in this phase. This is another phase, I have connected this one the resistances, again this one, this resistance I will connect to the third phase, that is R by B. I have connected the three resistance for the different phases. Okay, so if I control the voltage, that means if I change the voltage by using the resistances, I call it rheostat or simple called external resistances, because as we know that any resistance there is a voltage drop occurs. Okay, so due to the voltage drop here, suppose I applied the 400 volt, but suppose I connected the external resistance in the series of the stator winding, so due to the voltage drop here, the stator voltage get reduces. Okay, and if the stator voltage get reduces, obviously speed will get reduces. Okay, so this method is only used to get the speed below the normal value. Okay, so if I my normal value of speed is about near about 1500 rpm or 1500 rpm, so below that 1500 rpm I am getting suppose I want to control the speed, then I should prefer this method, stator voltage control method. Okay, by using the external resistances. Now this is nothing but a thyristor voltage controller. Thyristor voltage control means just I have connected the different thyristors here, this one I have connected different thyristors, so that by changing the firing angle of the thyristors which is connected in antiphase, that means here each phase I have connected the two thyristors, I call it the pair of thyristors. Here also same for the every phase or each phases. Now if I control the firing angle of this thyristors, then obviously the voltage which is going to apply of induction this stator of induction motor will change, and hence the if I change the applied voltage, then obviously the speed will change. Okay, so this method we are used for the stator voltage control methods. Okay, as I just said, in this I can change the stator voltage by using any means. That means you can use this one by using this one, say third one or track control. You can take any one method to control the stator voltage. Okay, so I mentioned what stator voltage control method. It is used to obtain the speed below the rated value. Okay, only I want to, suppose I want to get the speed which is below the rated value, I can prefer the stator voltage control method. But the disadvantage, this method is very simple. Advantages, this method is very simple. Okay, but disadvantages, suppose I am using the external resistances in the series circuit of the stator I shown here, then obviously there is a power losses takes place, because if I control the current, I square R losses takes place, and again power losses takes place. As well as if I control, this means if I control the voltage, that means if I change the voltage, then obviously the torque of that induction motor will change. That means if I change the supply voltage, obviously the torque of induction motor will change. Now if the torque of induction motor will change, now suddenly there is a drastic effect on the operation, that is the performance of induction motors. That means if I changing the voltage continuously, then there is a this effect on there is a drastic effect on the performance of induction motor, that will reduces the life as well as the efficiency of induction motors. Okay, so again we will move towards the second point. It's a nothing but a pole changing method. Okay, this is nothing but it's a pole changing method. So the pole changing method is one of the main methods of the speed control of an induction motor. Okay, this method of controlling the speed बाइपोल चेंजिंग इज यूज्ड मेनली फॉर स्क्विरल केज मोटर ओनली. ओके, जस्ट रीड द सेंटेंस केयरफुली. दिस पोल चेंजिंग मेथड्स वी आर ओनली यूज फॉर स्क्विरल केज मोटर ओनली बिकॉज द केज रोटर दैट इज वी कॉल्ड स्लिपरी इंडक्शन मोटर ऑटोमेटिकली डेवलप्स अ नंबर ऑफ पोल्स विच इज इक्वल टू द पोल्स ऑफ स्टेटर वाइंडिंग. नाउ द स्क्विरल केज मोटर डजंट हैव एनी वाइंडिंग इन द रोटर एज आई सेड इन कंस्ट्रक्शन पार्ट्स. ओके, हेंस नाउ दिस मेथड दैट इज अ पोल चेंजिंग मेथड वी आर ओनली गोइंग टू अप्लाई ओनली ऑन अ स्क्विरल केज इंडक्शन मोटर बिकॉज फॉर द स्लिपरिंग इंडक्शन मोटर आई कॉल्ड अ केज रोटर दिस अनदर नेम ऑफ द स्लिपरिंग इंडक्शन मोटर. इफ आई अप्लाई दिस मेथड फॉर अ केज रोटर ऑटोमेटिकली डेवलप्स अ नंबर ऑफ पोल्स विच इज इक्वल टू द पोल्स ऑफ स्टेटर वाइंडिंग. दैट मीन्स वॉट? नाउ सपोज आई हैव चेंज एनी पोल्स ऑन द स्टेटर वाइंडिंग ऑब्वियसली द स्लिपरिंग इंडक्शन मोटर विल चेंज द इट रोटर्स इट विल चेंज द पोल्स ऑफ द रोटर वाइंडिंग्स. ओके, नाउ the number of stator poles can be changed by the following three methods. Okay, so pole changing methods, how we are taking this one? By using this, that means we have already seen 120 f upon p, this p, okay, ns p. Okay, so here now this number of stator poles can be changed by following three methods. First, multiple stator winding. Multiple means it's a more than one. Okay, multiple, there is a more than one stator windings. Second, method of consequent poles, method of consequent poles. And third one, pole amplitude modulation, I called a PAM. Okay, that means if I connect the more than one winding stator winding in the stator circuit, then I can change the pole. Second one, method of consequent poles, we will see. And third one is regarding the pole amplitude modulations. That means it's part of electronics system. So this method, this particularly pole changing method, which is used for the soft starter mechanism. Okay, so already we seen about a soft starter for induction motor. That particular soft starter includes this pole amplitude modulations. That means if I control the modulations of the particularly amplitude of the supply voltages, then obviously the pole will change. And this method we are used for the speed control of induction motor. Okay, so we will see one by one regarding the pole changing methods. Okay, so first part, it's regarding the multiple stator winding, which is the part of pole changing method. In the multiple stator winding method, two windings are provided on the stator which are wound on the two different number of poles. Okay, what I said, in the multiple stator winding method, two windings are two, that is a TW, two windings are provided on the stator which are wound on the two different number of poles. Okay, one winding is energized one at a time. Let us consider that the motor has a two windings for six and four poles. That means what? Just remember, for normal pole, normal induction motor, we have the fixed number of poles. Okay, for normal induction motor we have the fixed number of poles, but for particularly this pole changing method speed control mechanism, we should provide the two windings which has a different poles. Okay, the two windings, either there are two windings, may first winding may have the different pole, second winding may have different pole. So for that, again one winding energizes at a one at a time means at a time we can energize, we can give supply to any one winding. There are two windings I mentioned, two windings are in the stator winding and it has again two windings in which two winding has a different number of poles. Mhanje samjha majha motor madhe there are two windings are there, don windings ahet stator madhe and eka winding che number of poles vegle asnar ahet, dusra winding che number of poles vegle asnar ahet. Okay, now the doni peki at a time tumhi kutlyahi ekala at a time tumhala supply dyaycha, donile supply dyaycha nahiye, दोन्ही पैकी कुठल्या तरी एका वाइंडिंगला सप्लाय द्यायचा. ओके, नाउ लेट अस कन्सिडर दॅट द मोटर हॅज टू वाइंडिंग्स. ओके, फॉर सिक्स अँड फोर पोल्स. फर्स्ट वाइंडिंग हॅज सिक्स पोल्स, सेकंड वाइंडिंग हॅज फोर पोल्स. फॉर द फ्रिक्वेन्सी ऑफ 50 हर्ट्ज द सिंक्रोनस स्पीड विल बी 1000. हाऊ वी आर गोइंग टू कॅल्क्युलेट दिस वन? एन एस इक्वल्स टू 120 एफ अपॉन पी, जस्ट एज वी सीन दिस फॉर्म्युला. दिस वन, जस्ट रिमेंबर दिस फॉर्म्युला ऑलवेज. एन एस इक्वल्स टू 120 एफ अपॉन पी. If I p is equals to 6, If P is equal to 6 and supply frequency is 50, then just multiply it, you will get 6, that is, you will get 1000 RPM. Okay, similarly, if I apply the P is equal to 4 here, then 120 into 50 upon 4, you will get 1500 RPM. You can calculate it, you will get that same answers. If you are providing the number of P is equal to 6, then you will get NS, synchronous speed, is equal to 1000 RPM. If I am providing P is equal to 4, then you are getting number of pole equals to 1500 RPM, that is 1500 RPM. Okay, so here for the frequency, synchronous speed will be 1000 for the 6 pole and 1500 revolutions per minute is RPM for the 4 pole machines. This method of speed control is less efficient and more costly. More costly, why it is more costly? Because we have the two windings. Okay, we have the two windings, and because of that reason, the cost of the particular induction motor will increase, as well as the cost as well as size of induction motor will increase, because I should provide the two different stators and which has the two different number of poles. The poles are different, as well as number of poles are different, as well as the two windings are there. Obviously, the size of induction motor will increase. That is again because of this, it has increasing the cost of the induction motor. And because of the two windings, the I square R losses are more compared to single winding, and hence this machine is having less efficient. That means efficiency of that particular motors is less. Okay, now here in the method of consequent poles, this is the first method, multiple stator windings. So already we've seen about this one, multiple stator windings. What exactly we are doing? Just we are changing that, we are providing the two different windings, so that we will get the two different speeds. Okay, for that speed, synchronous speed, we will change, for that particularly motor, we will have the different number of poles, and so that we have different number of synchronous speed. And if I have different number of synchronous speed, I can change the actual speed, obviously, because actual speed mostly depends on the synchronous speed of induction motors. So second off, it's a method of consequent poles. Okay, in the method of consequent poles, a single stator windings is divided into few coil groups. Okay, the terminals of all these groups are brought out by simply changing the coil connections. The number of poles can be changed. In practice, the stator windings are divided only in two coil groups. The number of poles can be changed in the ratio of 2:1. That means in the method of consequent poles, a single stator winding is divided into few coil groups. That means ek winding hai, the winding mein mein kai kelashi जे कॉइल आहे म्हणजे पूर्ण एक आर फेज वाय फेज बी फेज तीन वायंडिंग असणार ना, त्या वायंडिंग मध्ये काय केलं असे नंबर ऑफ कॉइल्स केले, म्हणजे एका फेज मध्ये म्हणजे भरपूर कॉइल्स करत गेलो. एकच फेज कॉइल म्हणजे काय, असं फक्त वाउंड करत जायचं, जस्ट वी नोड द कॉइल. ओके, द टर्मिनल्स ऑफ ऑल दीज ग्रुप्स आर ब्रॉट आउट, दॅट मीन्स द आय हॅव कनेक्टेड ऑल दीज टर्मिनल्स वी आर टेकिंग द कॉमनली बाय सिम्पली चेंजिंग द कॉइल कनेक्शन. म्हणजे कॉइल मध्ये जर मी चेंज कनेक्शन चेंज केला, द नंबर ऑफ पोल्स कॅन बी चेंज्ड. ओके, म्हणजे मी काय केलं, एका जे फेज आहे, फेज मध्ये मी काय, समजा एक माझ्याकडे आर फेज आहे किंवा स्टेटर मध्ये तीन फेज असतात आर वाय बी, तर आर फेज मध्ये मी काय केलंय, एकच वाइंडिंग आहे, तर मी काय केलं कॉइल करत गेलोय. जस्ट कॉइल म्हणजे सिम्पल यु नो दॅट. ओके, मी फक्त वाउंडिंग वाउंड करत गेलोय. इफ आय प्रोव्हाइड द नंबर ऑफ कॉइल्स इन अ सिंगल फेज, म्हणजे एका आर फेज मध्ये नंबर ऑफ कॉइल्स केले, वाय फेज मध्ये नंबर ऑफ कॉइल्स, बी फेज नंबर ऑफ कॉइल्स, आर वाय बी कुठला आहे, स्टेटर वाइंडिंग मधला, तीन फेज आहेत. ओके, अगेन बाय सिंपली चेंजिंग द कॉइल कनेक्शन, कॉइल कनेक्शन चेंज केलं तर नंबर ऑफ पोल चेंज होतात. ओके, सो फॉर दॅट वी विल सी दिस वन. ओके, सो इथे मी काय केलंय बघा, माझं कसं आहे बघा, इथे मी काय केलंय, द फिगर बिलो शोज द सिंगल फेज ऑफ स्टेटर वाइंडिंग, म्हणजे एक फेज मी कन्सिडर केलंय कुठलंही. ओके, विच कन्सिस्ट ऑफ फोर कॉइल्स, म्हणजे कॉइल्स हे फोर कनेक्टेड आहेत. दीज कॉइल्स आर डिवाइडेड इंटू टू ग्रुप्स नेम्ड एज ए बी अँड सी डी, म्हणजे हे माझ्याकडे मी काय केलंय, इथं माझ्याकडे टोटली एकाच फेज मधले सगळं आहे, बरं का, हे एकच फेज आहे माझा. मग ह्याच्यामध्ये मी काय केलेलं आहे, इथं हे माझं फर्स्ट ए बी कॉइल्स आहे आणि सेकंड ते सी डी कॉइल्स आहेत. ओके, दिस इज फॉर फोर पोल्स. ग्रुप ए बी कन्सिस्ट ऑफ एन ऑड नंबर ऑफ कॉइल, दॅट इज 1:3, वेर एज ग्रुप सी डी कन्सिस्ट ऑफ इवन नंबर ऑफ कॉइल्स 2:4. ओके, म्हणजे इथं बघा, ए हे कुठे आहे बघा, ए आणि बी कन्सिस्ट ऑफ 1:3. ओके, 1 2 3 फोर कॉइल्स आहेत, 1 2 3 4, 1 कुठे बघा, ए ला 1 ला गेलेला आहे. इथून हे कुठे गेले बघा, जस्ट इथे गेले 1 3, इथं बघा, हे करंट बघायचा बघा, ए पासून गेलं. ओके, इथनं करंट फ्लो झाला, इथून इथं आलं, हे इथून पुढे गेले, इथं जस्ट 3 पर्यंत गेले, थ्री पास ना इथं आले. सिमिलरली सी कुठे गेले बघा, सी पासून गेले हे इथं एन, हे अगेन इट इज गोज टू द एन फोर, टू आणि फोर, दॅट इज ऑड. सो हियर एज अ मेन्शन दिस फर्स्ट देर आर फोर कॉइल्स ओके, सो नेमली एज ए बी सी डी. सो मेन्शन ए बी सी दॅट मीन्स ग्रुप ए बी कन्सिस्ट ऑफ एन ऑड नंबर ऑफ कॉइल्स, दॅट मीन्स ए बी ओके, ग्रुप ए बी कन्सिस्ट ऑफ ऑड नंबर ऑफ कॉइल्स. दिस फर्स्ट आणि थर्ड कॉइल्स आर कनेक्टेड टू द ए बी, वाईल वेर एज ग्रुप सी डी कन्सिस्ट ऑफ एन इवन नंबर ऑफ कॉइल्स, दॅट मीन्स ग्रुप सी डी दिस वन ओके. हे टोटल ग्रुप्स कुठे आहेत, हे सगळे जे ए बी सी डी जे आहेत हे सगळे एकाच फेज मध्ये आहेत, बरं का? टोटली एकाच, म्हणजे टोटल एका फेज मध्ये मी चार असे एक लूप केले किंवा चार कॉइल्स केलेले आहेत ओके. तर टर्मिनल्स ए बी सी डी आर टेकन आउट ॲज शोन इन द अबव फिगर, दॅट मीन्स ए बी सी डी आर टेकन आउट ऑन द ॲज शोन अबव फिगर ओके. द कॉइल्स आर कॅरिंग करंट इन द गिवन डायरेक्शन बाय कनेक्टिंग कॉइल ग्रुप्स आयदर इन सिरीज ऑर इन पॅरल ओके. दॅट मीन्स द डायरेक्शन ऑफ दिस करंट, द डायरेक्शन ऑफ दिस करंट कॅन बी चेंज बाय चेंजिंग द सिरीज ऑर पॅरल कनेक्शन ओके. सिरीज पॅरल कुणाचं, तर दीज फोर कॉइल्स. जस्ट रिमेंबर दॅट दीज फोर कॉइल्स इट इज द कॉइल ऑफ ओनली वन फेज ओके. ॲज आय कन्सिडर थ्री फेज इंडक्शन मोटर, सो अकॉर्डिंग दॅट आउट ऑफ दॅट थ्री फेज सपोज आय कन्सिडर ओनली वन फेज, देन फॉर कंट्रोलिंग द पोल आय कनेक्ट, आय शुड कन्सिडर देअर आय शुड हॅव द कॉइल्स ओके. इच फेज आय शुड मेड अ डिफरंट नंबर ऑफ कॉइल्स. फॉर सिम्प्लिसिटी आय हॅव शोन द फोर कॉइल्स. फॉर सिम्प्लिसिटी आय शोन दिस इज वन कॉइल, सेकंड कॉइल, थर्ड अँड फोर्थ कॉइल ओके. सो ॲज अ मेन्शन ग्रुप ए बी कन्सिस्ट ऑफ एन ऑड नंबर ऑफ कॉइल्स, दॅट इज ए बी जस्ट ऑड नंबर ऑफ कॉइल्स, वन दिस इज कॉइल वन, टू, थ्री अँड फोर, ऑड नंबर ऑफ कॉइल्स. दॅट मीन्स ए ए करंट जस्ट स्टार्ट टू फ्लोइंग फ्रॉम दिस, नाव इट विल फ्लो, जस्ट चेक द डायरेक्शन, नाव हियर इट विल गोज फॉर द थर्ड अँड अगेन इट कम्स बॅक टू द बी पॉइंट, जस्ट चेक द डायरेक्शन. ऑब्विसली सी इट इज गोज फॉर द सेकंड वन, हियर अगेन इट tries to flow from the d, that is d current direction, likewise d, now it is current is going from the fourth, now it comes back towards the n and now it goes towards the c okay. Just change the current directions okay, and the direction of this current can be easily changed by connecting these series, these coils in either series or parallel connections. We will see in the next slides okay. That means here just I mentioned about the different series coils okay. So I have again a b, that is a b c d, it is again it's single, it is the four coil connection for only one phases okay. This is a four coils, so I connected now first a b d c okay. A b d c means what will happen, a to b. Now previously it will flow from the a b c d, that means here A to B, A to B current flow होत होता, previously it is flowing from A to B. Now, now after that D to C, now again D to C, you can check D to again C here, D to C. Now, you can connect by any method, that means A, likewise this one. Now, what is happen here? Now, the current is start to flow from A to the B. Again to the C, it will change the directions okay. By means you can change the coil connections either series or parallel, and accordingly you can change the pole of the induction motors. This is regarding the pole changing method, which is regarding the method of consequent poles. And last one regarding the pole changing is pole amplitude modulation techniques okay. The pole amplitude modulation is a flexible method of pole changing which can be used in application where speed ratios other than 2:1 are required okay. 2:1 means what exactly? That 2:1 means what? It is the ratio between the synchronous speed and the actual speed, that is a 2:1 okay. So the motors are designed for speed changing based on the pole amplitude modulation scheme, as known as a pole amplitude modulation motors okay. That means the motor which are used this methods, that is the techniques, pole amplitude modulation, this particular speed control make, suppose the motor has using this technique for controlling the speed control, for controlling the speed of that induction motor, then this motors we call as a pole amplitude modulation motors, that means PAM, that is own amplitude modulation motor. So this actually used in the soft starter as well as stop start motors. Okay, so these all these parts are as I said, this part of electronics. So we are changing the modulations of the poles so that there is amplitude of there is a change. Changing the modulation of the amplitude, that is amplitude of the current. So obviously the current modulations are then the value of the pole will get changed. Okay, this is related with the pole changing motor. In this lecture we have seen about the first method. It is related with the first we have seen the stator voltage control method and second one pole changing method. Okay, so first stator voltage already seen about the three different points, and regarding the pole change again we have classified it. And for next lecture we will see about this rotor resistance control method, and last one variable voltage variable frequency method. Okay, thank you.